Hi, students. Today we are going to move on to a new topic. We are going to see how we can access files. And for accessing files, we are going to mainly focus on two things: how to read a file and how to write to a file. Okay? And let's do a very quick review. For the reference semantics, that is something we need to understand. How does Python handle the variables, variable names, and then the real values in the memory? So, for example, if we do x equals 10, and what happened behind the scene is we are going to have a variable name x, and there will be a value 10 as an integer created in the memory. Well, not now, but when I'm right-click and run the code, and that will be how Python handles this line of code. And eventually, there will be reference from x to 10, right? And the next thing we want to know is if we do y equals x. So that is, I create a new variable y, and that new variable y shares the same value with the x. So we have the variable name x, variable name y, and then both of them refer to the same value, and that is 10. Okay? And the similar thing is for the, say, if you have the list x equals, say, Python 131, challenging. Okay, and then if we have the list s, and then we do list y equals list x. That's the same thing. So but we have both two variable names, list x and list y, and they refer to the same list. So we didn't really do a real copy of the list. We just have two variables, and then they refer to the same variable in the main memory. And the weird thing will be, say, if I want to change the y, say y equals 20, and then if I want to print x, and you will see x will stay as 10. Okay, and then if I want to make a change to a list of y, say list y dot remove, and then I'm removing a string 131, and then if I'm printing the list x, and then well, you will see the list x will get changed. So for this one, our observation is unchanged, and for this one, our observation is changed. Okay, so the difference between the first version and the second version is the first one we are touching an integer, and an integer is immutable in the memory. So whenever we are changing the value of the y, we have to create a new object y as 20. Okay, and then for the list, that is a mutable data type in the memory. So when x and y, they refer to the same list. So if we want to change the y, and then we can make the in-place changes on a list. So well, when we change the y, list y, and then list x also get changed. Okay, and here are a few other things we want to talk about, like for example, making a copy. How do you make a copy? I mean a real copy of the Python list. And we can do, say, list x real copy. Okay, let me make it here. Okay, list x real copy equals list x, and then I'm making slicing like this. And after that, you will see the list x is changed. But if we want to check the list x real copy, I bet it's unchanged. So let me run this again. And ta-da! Okay, now we have a real copy because, well, later we are going to change the list y, and at the same time, the list x will also be changed. However, since we made a real copy of the list x, and that stays unchanged. Okay, and then here are a few things like if we want to print, let me copy this code. This x real copy dot count. Say if I want to count 131 without the quotes, and then I should get a zero, and that's right. And if I want to do the list, you want to do the count again, but with the codes, now I'm treating the 131 as a string, and then I should see one occurrence. So I'm gonna get a one. And what else? And then the index. Okay, and let me copy those two lines of code. And then instead of doing the count, I want to do index. And I want to do index here too. So for the first try, we are trying to get the index of the 131 in the listx real copy, but that 131 is 131. And for the next one, I'm going to get the index of the 131 as a string. And I suspect we are going to see an arrow. And yes, so this 131 as an integer is not a member of the list, and then Python will give us an arrow. So, well, let me comment this code out for now, because that doesn't work. We cannot get the index of a non-existing value from a list. And if we try the next one, we are going to have 1. And this 1 is the index of the 131 in the list. The list x copy, so that is here. Okay, so let's come back to today's topic, and we want to talk about the exception handling and then the file IO. So for the exception, we are seeing the exception every day, and we usually say that's an error message. Well, and or if you have a chance to sit with me and say, help, I need some help, right? And that is, those are the exceptions. And the exception will happen when Python doesn't know how to handle a certain cases. And for example, if there's a syntax error, or that's a runtime error. And there, for example, just now we have seen this one, right? So for this line, and if we just run this one again, and what's the arrow? And that is a value arrow, and the value arrow saying, okay, 131 is not in the list, and that is the exception. And well, usually we just let it happen, and we use that error message to figure out what's wrong with the code. And if we are writing the code for a big project, I mean thousands of lines of code, and if your code may have this kind of issue, and then the entire project is going to crash. And probably we want to do some prevention to handle some of the cases or some of the scenarios that we may have exception, instead of having a exception and crash everything in the program. And how do we do that? Well, that is, we can do a try and except. So for the try and except, and the syntax can be like this. So we try some part of the code, and usually we consider this part of the code as the risky part of the code. And you see the colon, and this means we are going to do an indentation. So we have a try block, and after that we also have an except block. And if in the try block there is an exception, and then we will shut down the running of the entire try block, and then we move down to the except block. And after we finish the except block, and if there is a finally block, and that finally block will be executed anyhow. And it doesn't matter if we finish the try block without an exception, or we are not able to finish the try block, well, the finally block will be executed anyhow. So let's see this example. So we want to try 1 divided by 0. And well, this cannot be done, and we are going to have a runtime error. So before you run this code, PyCharm won't give you any red line. However, when you run this code and you're going to have a runtime error, and then that means that's the exception, and then the except will be triggered, and we are going to print that was silly. And after that, we move on, and there is a finally block. and this finally block will be executed anyhow, doesn't matter if we have an exception or not. So, well, we have an exception here, and then we print that was silly from the except block, and we move down and we print this get executed no matter what from the finally block. Okay, so well, let's play with this code a little bit. Say, well, I really want to resurrect this line of code. Okay, I'm gonna do it, make a copy, oops, and then I want to make it here, and I want to do a try. So I want to try and see if I can get the index of 131 from the list X real copy. And if I can get that, and then it will be printed. And L, except. So well, this except will be triggered when there is an exception in the try block. So usually I can we can say this code, this line of the code is gonna fail when there's no such value 131 in the list. So I'm gonna print, hey, you want to check whether you have such value in the list. And then, okay, and I also want to do it finally, and I can say finally, colon, I want to do print, finished. I hope you have found the index, or go and check the list again. Okay, so the logic will be I want to try this code, and if it works, and then I'm gonna do nothing, and then I say finish, I hope, blah blah blah. Well, but if there's this line has a problem, and then we are gonna trigger the except, and I say this line, hey, you want to check whether you have such a value, and then I still want to print finish. I hope you find the value, or go back, go and check the list again. Okay, so let me run this. And since we know this line is gonna be problematic, we are gonna see those two. Let's run this. And ta-da, yes, we see those two lines of code. And let me expand this window a little bit. And the difference you see is, in this case, we do have a runtime error, but this runtime error doesn't really bring any error message down here. And instead, we are trying to do a little bit of error handling in our code, so we got some meaningful output to the user. Okay, and then let's try this. If we want to do the index of this 131 as a string, and we will see, okay, we are able to get the index of the 131, so that's good. And if that's good, there's no exception, and the except block won't be triggered. But eventually, we will move down, and we are going to do the finally. So the finally will be printed anyhow. So let me run this version. And you see, I got a 1, that is the index of the 131. And then I also print finish. I hope you have found the index, or go and check the list again. Okay, so that's a small example of how we can do error handling. And later in this course, we are going to do a little bit more of the error handling again. So I will see you in the next video.